formation of Mishmi Apex Body, MWS. A group of ethnic people with natural and social ties living in and around a particular hill ranges were designated as the Mishmis. With the passage of time, the hill ranges itself were named after the tribe, as the Britishers had done elsewhere, like as in the case of Dafla Hills, Abor Hills, Lusai Hills, Garo Hills, Khasi Hills, etc. And we have the Mishmi Hills. Mishmi in written records first appears in Ahom Buranji during the reign of Sutiyampa Nariya Raja, 1644 to 1648. Subsequently, the Ahom Mishmi Treaty in 1687, in form of Sadia Snake Pillar inscription, demarcates the Mishmi and Ahom territory. The important dimension of the period is that the Ahoms never divide the Mishmis. Ahoms adopted Hinduism and frequented the Lohit or Sanskrit Lohitia rivers, Brahmakun or Parshuram Kun. They paid taxes to the Mishmis to visit the Kun. However, the Ahom name for Lohit River as Tilau manifests the adoption of Mishmi Telu name of Lohit. This aspect suggests the strong correspondence between the Ahoms and the Mishmis. The division of Mishmis starts from the British accounts of Wilcox in 1825, and thereafter we find the three groups of Mishmis. In some instance, we find further division in form of Devijian Mishmis, the Mishmis of Ithuwedi. The earliest English books which had recorded Mishmis, like the Mishmi Hills by T.T. Cooper in 1873, Alexander Mackenzie, History of the Relations of the Government with the Hill Tribes of the Northeast Frontiers of Bengal, 1884, give detailed account of how the three Mishmis of Lohit and Dibang fought united against the British government for unjust hanging of Kesha Manu in 1855. In the later days, the academic writings of J.P. Mills, which was outcome of the extensive study in Lohit region, also contends that the various groups of Mishmis clan-wise are genealogically related. The Mishmis of Lohit Valley, Assam. This piece was published in Souvenir also, Golden Jubilee Souvenir of both Tamil Nadu and Ray. You can read it, you can access it, and it is the outcome of the research of Sri Sivamsa Chikro. And to inform the audience about this man, J.P. Mills, he was the director of ethnography of Assam in 1930, advisor to governor of Assam on tribal affairs 1943, professors at School of Oriental and African Studies, SAOS, London, in 1947, and he also was professor of Oxford University. So the study carried out by him was authentic and genuine. The establishment of Indian administrative system after 1947 and building of roads, etc., ushered in a new way of life among the tribe. The earlier traditional way of life in many cases were replaced by the new way of life. This aspect impacted the correspondence among the Mishmis of different sections. At times, political differences among the prominent leaders also seem to have adversely impacted the formation of single apex body. The developments in different parts of the states more than two decades ago in the form of single apex body for tribal groups have opened the eyes of the educated Mishmis. We have witnessed the role of Arunachal's unified community-based organization in multi-sphere, uplifting the social, political, and cultural and economic of their tribe. Sub tribe ka apex body ban chuka hai combined, lekin hum log ka Mishmi bahut late hua hai banne mein. And Mishmi apex body formation committee had existed earlier also. There was also a union called Mishmi Student Union in IGG College, which was founded by Sri Barom Masong and his friends. And in the later days, there were also talk about all Mishmi forum, but it didn't go ahead. It is also noteworthy to mention the efforts of Aimsilias and Kalsom under the leadership of Sri Kelo Pulu, Sri Tone Mikro, Sri Bajai Pul, Sri Bakrim Chikro, Sri Somadon Tausik, Sri Inju Lingi, Sri Andhua Miu, Sri Pugelam Tega, and Sri Suraj Tayan for Unified Body. You all have done so much for the Unified Body, and you are the people who have pioneered for this formation of MWS. However, the unification momentum reached new heights with the formation of Mishmi Welfare Society, MWS, at Itanagar in 2013. The first ever joint Kalsom Aimsilias and MWS meeting was held in Hawaii on 12 September 2014, which was convened by Kalsom under the chairmanship of Sri Bajaj Pool, a committee was formed to work out the modalities of the Apex Mishmi organization. The Hawaii Declaration constituted a Mishmi Apex Body Formation Committee. So here in 2014, the state started, and now here after 7 years, we are here forming the full-fledged Apex Body. And next meeting was held in 24 September 2017, after nearly 3 years. So the details I have shared in the WhatsApp group, you can bring it out. I won't read more. Just I would like to single out some of the points here. The resolution which was passed in 24 September 2017, one of the resolution reads, the recent developments in the state where communities have been watching for their social political interests to the government are alarming in nature. Therefore, we the Mishmis also need to organize in order to protect our interests. The Mishmis cannot shut their eyes towards the development like development of Tirap and Changlang. And Parkai Autonomous Region, Mon Autonomous Region, and Ministry for Abotani Affairs. In the long run, if the Mishmis don't remain vibrant on political issues, we will be marginalized in our own land. Therefore, we the Mishmis need to be united and organize ourselves for better tomorrow. So this was the resolution which was passed in 24th September 2017 at Teju here during the Kemeha celebration. Next meeting was held in 6th February 2019, which was called by Dr. Nikom Po, chairman of MWS, and where the joint committee again passed the resolution to form the Apex Body and make the MWS Itanagar unit as the interim Apex Body of the Mishmis. And next meeting was organized in 26th February 2019, and again this was on the issue of the militant issue in Kathan, and joint delegation of Kalsom, MWS, AMSU and AMSU, AMCDS went to Kathan and showed their solidarity with the people who are inflicted with the terrorism. On 1st March 2019, the delegate went to Kathan and the memorandum about the same was submitted to DC Lohit. And in 15th June 2019, again, there was this second meeting which was held, next meeting which was held in Jolang, where joint sitting was organized by the MWS Itanagar unit, and where it was decided to form the Apex Body, bring in the new Apex Body. And next sitting happened in 16th October 2019, where in IGT College, the bylaws and all of MWS Apex was passed. And next happened in 29th January, where the selection committee sat together and they formed the executive member of MWS. And next happened in 29th November, where the November 2020, where the regular executive members were selected. So therefore, today on this day we gather here on this historic day, 21st February 2021, in Tamil Nadu ground Koraliyang, swearing in ceremony of the full-fledged MWS executive members. With immense pleasure and gratitude, I, on behalf of the community, thank all who have worked hard to make this day see the light. I thank the leaders of our organizations, MCLS, Kalsom, and MWS, under the leadership of Sri Kelopulu, Sri Tone Mikro, Sri Bajaipul, Sri Bakrim Chikro, Sri Somadan Tosik, late Sri Inju Lingi, late Sri Andua Mihu, Sri Suraj Tayang, Sri Lupalum Kri, Dr. Sopai Tosik, Sri Ginko Lingi, Sri Bafensu Pul, Sri Rao Dele, Dr. Mika Umpo, Dr. Anil Bili, and Mishmi Apex Body Formation Committee members, Sri Shivamso Chikro, Sri Raju Mimi, Sri Barum Masong, Sri Sunil Mo, and Dr. Rasto Mena. Again, for having foresight and understanding the gravity of the situation, I especially thank again the gentlemen who worked tirelessly to give this Apex Body a shape. Again, let me thank Sri Ginko Lingi, President IMCLS, Sri Bafensopul, Chairman Kalsom, Dr. Mika Umpo, Chairman NWS, and my comrade Dr. Rasto Mehra. This historic day is for introspection and contemplation. When we glance at the history, the Mishmi community have come a long way by rallying soldiers and asserting our rights and freedoms with the Chutia Empire, Ahom monarchs, colonial British, the Tibetan encroachment, and with Suthi great earthquakes and Chinese Red Army. The past, as it shows, was not a bed of roses, but the sheer Mishmi character for existence and adaptation have led us to the present position. The time is now for to remember, introspect, and work for our collective aspirations. Ahoms were the longest ruling dynasty of the world. Against them also we face them also for the sake of our place, our tribe. The same was with the Britishers. British expeditions happened 4 times here, and the Mishmis of Anjao and Lohit, they blocked the British route, trade route towards Tibet. But now the things have changed, and we have to introspect. And at the cost of their own reputation, they fought against those invading forces. Now we are minority in our own place. There was the time when Hindu pilgrims used to pay taxes to visit Pashuramkund. Now the situation has changed. Now they are getting every year 30 to 40 crore for maintenance of that river. But now we are in a very different sphere. So these are the things to be introspected. Why we are outnumbered in our own place? Why we are back this way? The ruins of palaces and temples in the Mishmi Hills and long correspondence with the Buddhist Tibetans and Khamtis manifest that our forefathers existed with organized religion but preserve our unique Mishmi culture. Let today be the day on which the sons and daughters of Mishmi Hills resolve to preserve our rich culture and integrity of the tribe. Let ancient rivers Telu and Talo give wisdom to us and make us see that the deplorable condition Mishmis are in today is because in the recent times we have striven less jointly for the tribe. Hope that the Mishmi Welfare Society from today, through various endeavors, touch every aspect of the Mishmis, what we are and what we stand for. Long live the Mishmis and Mishmi Hills. Thanks.